All right, so it's hips again today.
Okay.
Hips 102.
So we'll get, even though the fire is on, we'll just start to warm up.
Do you want me to turn it off?
No, it's good. Have you ever done hot yoga?
My sister has.
Yeah. This one is really good to warm up your whole body. So inhale. Because what we've been doing are like static poses. So in some traditional lineages, you do have to do the whole sun salutation to warm up, which is, you know, up dog, down dog, Tadasana. Trying to squeeze your palms together. See how mine are together, but and now it's more hard. And then try to pull your arms back a little bit. Unless it hurts, but if you can, do it like that. And now keep your arms in place and come down. Bend your knees a little bit so you don't stress your back. Straighten your back and inhale. Back down. And start to slowly come back. Leave your arms drooping. Pushing yourself down, you're like pushing your hips out to the left. And then inhale, back up. Lift to the left. Let yourself all the way in. Inhale and straighten your back and look forward. And exhale back down as you kind of get a little deeper. And now slowly come back up. Now we're just going to walk out into downward dog. Take a few breaths here. slowly bring your chest forward over your hands so you're in plank. Good, yeah. So when you're in plank, imagine like you're tucking your hips a little bit and lifting at your waist to make your body even more straight. And now slowly come down on your knees and exhale and all the way back. Next inhale, slowly come back up to the table. Drop your belly, inhale, look up. And then exhale, roll your back, like round your back, really slow and deep. And exhale, and your mouth back. You do this like undulation. Inhale forward. We kind of only warm up our spine a little bit with that first exercise. Can you feel a little deep? Mm-hmm. Deep. Oh, okay, good. Pull yourself up. See the sky.
Well, the sun's like peeking out right on the other side of that tree.
Yeah.
The Studio Bank flag is flying. So it's, and it's flying that direction. So you have to turn.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to, I think we did this once in the summer, but this is another thing that's good for your hips. So you're going to, you lift, it's called flag drink. So it's kind of funny because you lift your leg all the way up like that, so your leg is parallel with the floor, your thigh is, and then you bring it back, and then bring it down behind your other knee. Yeah, and now you bring it back up, and bring it to touch your elbow. So bring it forward all the way as far as you can, yeah, like this, and then you bring it back up.
Oh, you don't touch it?
Yeah, yeah, and then bring it back. So it's this whole sweeping movement. So you're exhaling, and you add your breath in once you get used to the movement. You exhale forward, and then inhale, and you go back. Back and place it down. We'll do the other side. More. Okay, sit back, child pose. breath, look up with your hands and just bring slide your chest out a little forward. Inhale, cobra, and exhale down. Let's do this a couple times. Inhale up, and exhale, put your left ear on the mat and take a deep breath. And then one breath and then inhale back up. And then exhale back down. Put your right ear on the mat. Take a deep breath. And then I want to just grab your strap.
On my stomach?
Yeah. And you want to put your strap behind your foot. When you do that, let me help you. Here, just stay there. It's better for help you. So you're going to put it right here. Right there. Just one?
Yeah.
And then you're going to pull that forward. So
try to kick up if you can. Like before you pull it, you want to kick up as much as you can. Can you do that? So you're not just pulling it, you're trying to kick up and pulling it at the same time.
But just, you know, not to take it easy. Don't do it too hard, but you want to be, do you feel that stretch in the front of your thigh?
Yeah, on my stomach too.
Okay, keep doing it. Helps your spine too. You kind of your back arches a little bit. Pick up as much as you can on your own too while you're doing that. Place your left arm out, and then just push your other arm, push yourself over. Center. And put both your arms out like this. This is the airplane, it's called. And you're going to take a deep breath. And then on your inhale, you're going to squeeze your legs together and lift your chest up and come up as far as you can. Squeeze your thighs together. You're lifting up your whole body. It's a little harder to breathe. And then come down. breath. And then get yourself in position, and we'll do that again. So squeeze your legs together and come up. Do it one more time. So this time, push your arms down and your legs come up. Yeah. And then let go. And now you're going to put your hands next to your chest. Inhale, brings you all the way up. And up dog. And now come up to your tabletop, or just roll over your, you do tabletop to down dog, or go up dog to down dog, whichever one you feel like. Now down dog. And then drop your, remember to press down with your forefinger and thumb.
No, I'm trying to get my feet to go
flat. Oh, well, you can't always do that, so, but you need a shorter stance. Walk up one step. A little more. Yeah. I'll rotate your arms, your shoulders open a little more, and drop your head. Go your head. Good, yeah. And now come down to your knees. And you're going to step your right foot up. Yeah, so a little more. So you see how my back leg is slanted? Well, yeah, do you need a pillow for your knee? Just let your head open up here. Deep breath and then exhale yourself out a little back. Can you stretch that? Yeah. And then you inhale, come back. And just hold that again. And then lower it again. Curl your back toes under and push yourself up like that. Alright, now can you kick your leg back without
moving your leg? I can walk back.
Yeah, that's fine. And come back to plank just for a couple breaths. It's hard. So lower your, lower your butt a little. Come back to child's pose. Take a couple deep breaths. And then in the next breath, start to slowly your chest all the way forward. Come in the up dog. So you're on the tops of your legs. Push your leg like this. So you see if you can get your flat tops of your feet come up. So you're actually holding.
I don't think I can do that.
That's fine, you don't have to. Yeah, just for a second. Not come to tabletop. Yeah, and now down dog again. And now we're gonna transition to either come down to your knees and go step forward into pigeon, or you can step up with your foot under. The first one, you might just want to stay there. See how you feel. Scoot your hips all the way back. Pull your back toes under, push yourself up, and walk your foot back to plank again. One more time. Stay in plank for 2 breaths. And then just send your hips up and back. And down dog again. Start to take baby steps forward, top of your mat, so you're in a forward fold here. Just let your body hang, but kind of micro bend your knees. And kind of can reset yourself. So inhale. And kind of, when you do that, it kind of lets you get a little deeper into the fold. And then let your upper body go slowly, bring yourself up. So you exhale, bend your knees and swoop your hands all the way down. Keep your knees bent, but come up. So now we don't really do chair that much, but it's really good actually. Now we're in chair. Bring your arms up. Yeah, that's good. You're going to take a deep inhale and exhale. Bring your left arm under your right. And keep your knees bent. And bring your left knee over top of. If you can't do, maybe you want to hold on to the thing or to the buffet. Just see how you feel with your balance. Because the point is to squeeze your hips together in this posture. The arms are extra, so hold on to the buffet. Yeah. So hold on there. Yeah. Come down first. Well, hold on to it. Because we don't usually do this as a no for you, so just hold on. And then lift your leg up and bring it over. So you want to squeeze your hips in really tight as you can. So you do that first, and then once you feel comfortable, then you can add in the eagle arms, as they call it. Do your legs first, because your legs are what's the point of this exercise right now. Okay. swoop your arms down. Chair, you're kind of like tucking your hips a little bit, so you don't arch your back, you don't stick your butt out. Tuck your hips under, and you want to actually separate your knees. So open your feet a little wider. Yeah. Let's just do the arms only, so your right arm comes under, you can kind of swing it.
Is that okay?
Yeah, just do as best you can. I can lift them up. Okay, now let go of your arms and try the other leg. So hold on to the buffet, now we're gonna do the legs. To bring your right leg over your So at this point you want to just squeeze your thighs together as much as you can. The harder you squeeze your thighs together, the easier it is to actually balance. Start to bend your knees and swoop down. And we'll just do this chair one more time. And then you start to come up and forward. Down. And inhale, straighten your back and look up. And then exhale, fold that down. All the way back up, slowly rotating your mat. And exhale, float down again. This time you're going to plant your hands down and step your right foot all the way back. Your left foot. Take one breath here. Now inhale, start to slide your chest forward. Head it out. Inhale, back up to cobra and come down. Take a deep breath. Transition either to table to down dog or all the way straight to down dog. And now we're going to step your left foot 1 foot forward. Yeah, a little more. Your left foot 1 foot forward more. Yeah, and now step your right foot up to your right heel. Okay, it's fine. Okay. Now can you come up? Yeah. And now square your body over your right leg. And inhale, kind of lift up. And exhale, come back down. And try to touch your forehead to your knee.
you know, do that movement and you can release and let go. Just try that a couple times. And now either bring your hands in prayer or leave them separate and slowly come up. And make sure you're using your core to bring you up. All the way up. So yeah, good. So your hips are facing forward, remember, for warrior one. So both of your hip bones are facing like the front of your mat. Straighten your leg and you're gonna come back over. And release your hands and try to touch your forehead to your knee one more time. And plant your hands down. Alright, then walk your foot, your right foot back to your left foot. Okay, turn down dog again. And now we're going to transition to that other side. So, however you want to transition, down to your knees and then forward. Or the point is to get to the warp. So your stance is a little too far. Yeah. So your toes should be pointing, your back toes, point them kind of, yeah, exactly. And now square your body up over that left leg. Inhale, lift your body up to kind of release it, and then exhale back down. And touch your forehead to your knee. And you can just kind of take this in stages because it is easy to do. So you just kind of do it and then release yourself and then try again. And bring your hands in prayer. And slowly bring yourself up using your abs all the way up. And your knees bent and then warrior one. Alright, so now bring your right hip forward. Your hips are so your hips, you kind of are squeezing your thighs together when you're in warrior one.
Oh, that's what you're supposed to do.
Yeah, so like see how my hip, both of my hips are facing forward? Your stance is maybe a little too far, yeah, like that, perfect. So you're to get your hips both facing forward, you're squeezing your thighs together. Try to touch your forehead to your knee. Cool. And now we're going to step that left leg or walk it back to meet the right one. And leave your knees all the way down. Stand up on your knees. Bring your shoulders back. Give you some relief. To see the position now. Good. Oh, it's good, you're sweating. Bring your legs out straight and inhale. Out and up. And now make sure you're leading with your chest first. Start to come down over the tops of your legs, and when you feel like your back can't stretch anymore, then you just let your upper body come down. And actually, yeah, this is where you'll grab your strap. Yeah. And make sure when you use your strap, you're just using it to get a deeper stretch in the targeted area so you're not overstretching your back. I think I've found that it seems, other than like knees and shoulders, the backs are the things that a lot of times get injured in yoga. because it's so easy to overdo it and you don't even feel it, you know, necessarily. So let that one go. Cross your legs. And sit up really straight. And then again, we'll come forward. Leave your right leg there and remove your left one and bring it back behind you like that. And sit up as straight as you can and again come back over your front shin. So try to turn your body as much as you can to the left so that you can get yourself. So you're sitting up like this, straight, and then you turn yourself. Turn your torso to the left. Yeah. Now go over your shin. And you inhale, sit up. Straighten that right leg out. We'll leave the left one just like that. And come back. As much as you can.
You don't want to be on your shoulder or your elbow.
Some reason my left hip is like really tight. It's very frustrating. I can't even go back that far.
I can't go back with both.
Yeah, I mean sometimes I can, but today no. Which is kind of typical. But when you're in this position, you wanna wherever you are, keep your. You don't want, when you go back, if it's too much, it arches your spine. You want to kind of keep your back straight, so you want to tuck your chin a little bit. Right, now we're going to switch sides. So we're going to forward. So we're just going to switch. We're going to do this one first. So you're going to sit up and turn your torso. Sit yourself back up and straighten your left leg and come back now as much as you can. Slowly work yourself back up. And I'm going to take that right leg and bring it over the left. This we're used to doing this one. You want to try to have this right foot flat on the floor as much as you can. And then sit up, and you inhale, and then exhale. Turn your body through the arm. Twist. And tall. And then exhale, twist yourself around. Let's take it a little bit deeper, so we're going to keep it like just like that, just bend your other leg, so bend your right leg underneath your left, yeah, so I'm trying to bring a different dimension to that left leg bent, bring the right knee over. It up. Cross your legs. I'm going to show you a new one that we'll see. This one we haven't really done, but I think it'll be good. So you're going to spread your legs out, your knees apart pretty wide, like as wide as your mat, and kind of like sit back on your shins. So spread your legs out wider. Your knees. Can you face me instead of facing that way? Yeah.
So my legs are bigger than the mat.
Yeah, that's why.
I also have a contusion right there.
Okay. Do you need a pillow?
I don't know.
How does it feel?
Try it. Well, I can feel it a little bit. But that's it.
So now we're going to sit back and you're going to try to sit, go. So it's like we did half Virasana. So this is, I'm trying to get, you're going to come. come back as much as you can. Can you go back at all? It's better if your knees are wider. See how wide my knees are?
How do I do that without my feet being on the mat?
Do you need, you don't need your feet on the mat, do you? Or does it hurt?
I thought it would hurt. That's what I thought. Sick. Yeah, because there's no cushion. It's like hard.
How does it feel?
It just hurts my feet and my knee.
I know. It's does it hurt a, like just a little bit, or does it hurt a lot?
Well, it hurts that it's...
Can you lift your feet up? Okay, now. But your feet should be wider. Bring your feet. Yeah, like that. So you don't have to do... Just do however it feels right now.
I don't think I can put my weight on that part of my knee.
Okay.
I thought it was healed, but... It's still sore.
Do you think you could do it with a pillow? Here, let me get that one small pillow.
I need to blow my nose too, because I can't breathe.
This is actually very healing for your knees. That's why I'm showing it to you. Because it hurts me too, actually. And I used to be able, before I had my last surgery, I actually could go all the way back. Like, Skipper! Oh, Skipper! Downward dog, good boy.
How did you get that on the video?
You want to do yoga, don't you?
I'll show you how to do it.
So, you see, but your feet need to be wider apart.
Wider than this?
No, your feet are close. Your knees are wide, but your feet are close. Yeah. You bring your feet apart. And, like I said, don't feel pressure to, you know... But just try. So how does that feel?
I don't feel my knee's not hurting right now, so I got past that. I don't think my weight's on my knee, on that sore part of my knee. I feel it in the upper part of my thigh.
Yeah, so if we do this every day, eventually you can just try to stay a couple more breaths. Unless it hurts, and then let's just... Well, we're at the end of class anyways.
Yeah.
So that'll be something we can work on because
it's
painful for her. Yeah, it really, so once you do that, you want to straighten your, so it, what happens is it cuts off all the circulation in your knees, and then when you come out of it, it rushes the blood back into that area.
That's probably really good.
Yeah. So that's why it helps you. Anytime, you know, it's just like with your breath, when you're holding your breath, it expands your lungs.
Yeah.
So that's the concept with that.
Cool.
So,
is it 7:30?
7:31.
Oh, perfect.
Okay.
Are we done?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're perfect. I don't have to do this anymore.
No, I love yoga. I didn't like that.
I know, I'm just going to do this one thing. A happy baby. You didn't like the Virasana, huh?
What's that?
Virasana is kind of, it can be...